know that this transaction has been very difficult for many people.
So he addresses it
in our community
first. Smart.
And we realize that it has triggered a range
of emotions.
And
he's the voice of the Browns. Like, he speaks for
And that, as well as the nature of the allegations, weighed heavily on all of us, myself, Kevin.
Well, Andrew's working, you know, man. Jimmy, he's got the golf shirt on.
DW, as well as the men and women up and down the organization who were involved in the decision making and vetting process. And it was because of the weight of the anticipated reaction and the nature of the allegations that really pushed us to do as much work as possible,
both
internally and externally, in terms of understanding the cases.
Not on ESPN.
Who Deshaun was as a person.
No, not yet.
And it was through this really 5-month odyssey, and the information that we were able to amass, the reference work, and obviously working.
So they were ready to move on from Baker 5 months ago.
Process.
That's why you watch Instagram Live.
That's what that tells you.
For Deshaun. I want to touch on a little bit the work that we did do. First it starts with, like I mentioned, the reference work, understanding and talking to people who knew Deshaun intimately, interacted with him frequently at different phases of his life, whether that's when
so
it was in Gainesville, Clemson,
or thought about, at least thought about, right?
Multiple people up and down, the Texans organization across multiple leadership regimes. We used independent, investigative resources,
PIs, folks,
the Harris County and Houston law enforcement community, in order to get an unbiased and well-rounded and comprehensive
just like everything Andrew Berry did,
on,
they did their homework.
The allegations. Mm-hmm. We didn't want it just to be one-sided. We used third-party legal counsel that allowed or to really analyze all the information that we
were
able to
collect. Boy, if it wasn't an issue, you'd feel he's not going to be suspended.
And I should note, because I know
with
a lot
all
has
the
been,
resources, who knows what the
said about
does.
This. We were advised by our attorneys.
There's no consistency.
We were advised against reaching out directly to the 22 women out of concern that it would be considered interfering with a criminal investigation.
Correct.
And it's this and all week. Several other reasons that made it important for us to use independent investigative resources that were unbiased and comprehensive so that we could get a full picture and full perspective of the criminal and civil cases. So it was through this time and through this work and what we learned about
Sports Center's got it
on. What we learned about Deshaun the person, what we learned about the civil and criminal proceedings. Working through due process and legal process that got us comfortable with Deshaun the person.
Knew
and
they would say that.
We realize we're not naive to the fact that there are
another thing.
Many
good.
People who aren't
Nobody's
as comfortable
smiling.
With this transaction
this
as we are today.
Right. Nobody's smiling with that.
They didn't bring the jersey out and do the whole
right. And maybe they do it at the end,
trade
but right now
it's to be evaluated over the long run. And we do think that there's a strong and detailed body of work about Deshaun, and we do have faith in him as a person. We're not naive to the fact that there's still work to do. I think Deshaun would be the first to tell you as
he's
we
tell you.
Integrate him into our organization
tell you coming up right
in the
here.
Cleveland community. But we do have faith that Deshaun will not only meet the expectations that we have of any player who we bring into the organization, but exceed them. And we are looking forward to having Deshaun as our starting quarterback for hopefully a long period of time. So with that, I'll pass it to Kevin.
Here we go.
Echo what Andrew said. This organization did a tremendous amount of work on Deshaun the person, a tremendous amount of background. I understand the concerns completely. I understand the questions. Like Andrew talked about, we understand that there are questions to be answered. I have confidence in the work that
so
we put
far
in.
They're playing
confidence
it.
Confidence in the extensive
straight.
Work that mm-hmm. our group put in to understand Deshaun.
What you can do?
I'm really looking
you
forward
know,
to coaching
I
Deshaun.
Well, you have to.
I know he's yeah. ready to get to work, and I'm looking forward to him being around his teammates. And really, I'm looking forward to him making a very positive impact in this community. And with that, I'll turn
so
it over.
They probably got a laundry list for him to do in the community.
Yes, first I want to say thank you to Dee and Jimmy Haslam and the Haslam family for giving me this awesome opportunity to be the quarterback of this historical organization in the Cleveland Browns. I want to thank AB and Coach Kevin for also giving me the opportunity to come here to join
really
this organization, join this locker room, to lead these guys and be a servant
He's
leader.
Very impressive.
And then another opportunity for, you know, this organization for me to come in here and have the opportunity to show this community, show this city, show this organization, show this locker room who the person I really am.
The task
is. And that's the main focus that I want to do is continue to show people who I really am and get my story out eventually.
Start with you.
Tom Withers,
Tom Withers,
hey, Sean, there are a lot of, as Andrew and Kevin mentioned, there are a lot of people that are very conflicted over your arrival here. They've read the sexual allegations. They've seen the lawsuits. What do you want people to know about you as a person? Who are you? We know about you as a player. Who are you as a person?
The biggest thing for me is, as a person, I'm genuine. I'm hardworking, servant leader, who loves to be social in the community. Who loves to give back, very kind
he
of
was
team
all
oriented.
That in Houston,
so I love hanging out with my teammates.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But also, I
Can
want
I
to be able to show that eventually and get out
yeah.
into the community.
I don't want to.
I've always been hands-on in the community of Houston, back home in Gainesville, back home in Clemson. And that's what I want to do, is be able to get back to that brand.
I love
or
his orange
get back
tie,
to that person that people knew.
Suit's
kind of
nice too. I'm not a pinstripe guy, but it's nice. Looks good on
you. Yeah, Andrew, just to be clear, nobody from the Browns or representing the Browns spoke to any of the 22 women who've made allegations, correct?
Like I mentioned earlier in my opening statement,
you weren't allowed to.
Our attorneys advised.
Neither did any of the other teams.
Right.
Be considered
the Falcons, the Saints, the Panthers, they didn't either.
That's the reason that we did hire independent investigators to make sure that we could get that comprehensive and holistic perspective.
The investigators you hired did speak to the women?
I'll say the investigators that we hired were able to get a full perspective of all the cases. Yes.
Not speaking.
I'm going to say they full perspective of all the cases.
You're
I'm
not
going
to get him to say something he doesn't want to say.
Everything the investigators did, but they got full perspective for all the criminal and civil cases, Jake.
Not speak to the women. What is the basis for calling your investigation extensive, as you put it in your statement, on Sunday, and also given the fact some of the women haven't given sworn testimony yet. Mm-hmm. They don't have anything on the record.
Yeah, so again, Jake, I'll refer back to my statement. The independent and unbiased investigators were able to be comprehensive in all the information that they were able to bring forth. Some of the information, quite honestly, I understand can't necessarily be public, but we do feel good about the work that we did. We feel good about the work that the investigators
again,
did for us. We got a comprehensive
if they say
perspective
yes,
of the cases.
Then we could use that in the civil case.
Andrew, when you were investigating the situation with Deshaun, how much were you looking into whether the acts were criminal or whether the acts, whether or not
people,
they were criminal, did not rise to the standard of player conduct that you would expect from a player.
How many people?
Yeah, both things were considered.
I know, but I didn't promote it at
yeah,
all.
That's fine.
Did you come to a conclusion that the acts in the past were not beneath the standard you would expect, or did you reach the conclusion that that won't happen again or anymore now that he's a Cleveland Brown?
You know, I'll go back to, we felt good about everything
that
we felt. We felt good about Deshaun as a person. We felt good about what we learned about the cases, Doug, that to a point where we felt comfortable pursuing the trade and bringing him into the building. And if we didn't, like, in terms of what happened moving forward,
Browns were comfortable with everything. They're going to say after talking to him.
Deshaun, one of the reasons you're here is
Rosie
from Houston. Why did you ask? Why did you want out of Houston?
The biggest thing was, I think at the time, we just both were going in different directions. And so for me to be able to accomplish the things that I want to do, you know, we started off doing it privately with my agency, and then it led to, you know, the whole big situation. But yeah, we just, it was a time for both of us to kind of part ways.
A couple months after they had given you a new contract, so what triggered your change of sentiment?
I think for this circumstance in this situation, it's hard to get too far into the details. But yeah, it was just, like I said before, it was just a time for both of us to part ways. I know that previously the contract was given to me that summer. But at the same time, I was honest and straightforward with the organization. They were honest with me, and we came to the conclusion that this was the best
situation. Yeah, they wanted a tank. They didn't want to...
I think as
they got rid of the best wide receiver in the league,
Hopkins. Why you used the number of massage therapists that you've used.
Bill O'Brien.
Right,
yeah. Yeah, I can't get too far into detail because there's an ongoing investigation still. But I can say that with this now day and age, especially with my age group, social media is a big business part that goes into it. So that's, you know, a factor into it. But as far as the details, I can't get too far into it because there's an investigation going on. But hopefully, you know, once everything is resolved, I can speak freely on it.
Are you kind of reevaluating your methods or how many you use or how you find people?
Definitely. This is something that with my team and now with the Cleveland Browns and the organization, we find a plan and move forward from it.
Deshaun, what can you say to Browns fans and to the people of Cleveland to convince them that you're not the person that is described in these complaints?
Nothing is the answer to that. I want to know why he chose the Browns and no one asked you.
To believe that right now, given the sheer numbers involved.
No, definitely. I understand the whole circumstances is very difficult, especially for the women's side of the fans in this community. I'm not naive to that. I know these allegations is very, very serious, but like I've mentioned before, I've never assaulted any woman. I never disrespected any woman. I was raised by a single parent mom who has two aunties who's her sister.
Good answer.
And that's who raised me. I was raised to be genuine.
You're not gonna change.
I respect everyone
and
everything.
No matter what you say.
So I've always defended that, and I will continue to stand on that.
Right.
I just want the opportunity to be able to show who I really am in the community and be hands on and help people and serve other people.
Boy, that was A+ answer right there.
I was just wondering, why did you think Deshaun was worth the risk of a groundbreaking contract, especially with the uncertainty of, you know, possible NFL action, and just what convinced you that, how risky do you feel this is?
Yeah, Marla, it's a good question. For us, you know, once we got comfortable with Deshaun as a person, Deshaun the person, it became pretty straightforward from a football perspective. You know, we think he's, you know, one of the best, you know, players at the position in the sport. You know, he's obviously in his prime, and we think it's the most important position in the sport. So once we were able to, you know, get comfortable with, you know, him as a person, the football part in terms of evaluation was pretty easy.
Deshaun, you originally turned down the Browns.
And there you go, Tier. Good job, Tier.
How much of that had to just do with the contract?
Actually, it had nothing to do with the contract. I didn't know about the contract until I told my agent that I wanted to come and be a Cleveland Brown. That was secondary. That was after the fact that we spoke on the phone with AB and Kevin. And
do you believe
the
that?
Haslam family.
So I believe
that had nothing to do with me choosing the Cleveland Browns.
Why did you originally turn them down?
It wasn't necessarily a turn down. I think the media was kind of rushing me to make a decision, and I wasn't comfortable with making that right decision. And so the, you know, news get out and things like that. But, you know, for me, I knew that Cleveland was the best situation for a football standpoint and just for a
somebody asked you about the weather
atmosphere. And these guys mentioned
talk football, Russo.
I sit up here, Coach Kevin and AB and the Haslam family. It was just that connection that we just had, that bond. And I knew that this was the perfect situation for me to have a fresh
boy,
start.
Boy, so far, so good for this
Super
kid.
Bowls and move forward.
This is a tough spot, man, for anybody.
As well, right. We want to right. Build it as.
I don't care how savvy you are.
And to your point earlier, he's Deshaun, starting this to is practice
something that is going to stick with you for a long time, this perception. How do you repair your image? How do you restore your name?
No, I understand that, and I know that there's going to be a stain that's probably going to stick with me for a while, but all I can do is keep moving forward and continue to show the person that I am, the true character, the true person, the true human being I am. Like I said before, I've never done the things that these people are alleging.
There you go.
Continue to
sounds like they're hunkering down. I'm going to tell you something. It sounds like they're not paying anybody.
Cooperate with everything that comes with it. And just keep moving forward. And then as far as the job and what I need to do as a, on the football side is to lead this team, help this team win multiple games and Super Bowls. And that's my job, is to continue to put all that together and work with the Cleveland Browns. And, you know,
boy, for SportsCenter to take this thing for as long as they have.
When did you know that, or I should say, when did you feel comfortable?
I haven't heard any Nationals ask the question yet.
No, but I get it. The local people should
face the first question.
Usually they're not that nice, the Nationals.
Daryl, I don't know that I can pinpoint a specific moment, but it was a long process. Like I mentioned, it was a 5-month odyssey. And, I don't know that I know the specific day or time, but it really was a combination of all the factors. And as we were able to accumulate more and more information, the pure volume of it and the amount of time and work that we place into it, that's ultimately what got us comfortable with him.
Yeah, the 5 months comment. If this is a
November.
Yep. Tony's going there. Watch.
So did you make a decision you were going to replace Baker Mayfield?
There you go, Tony.
No, it's a good question, Tony. So
yeah.
That's typically the time of the year that we begin our planning for the next offseason.
So they're not planning for nobody in Kansas City. You're not planning in Buffalo in October.
Your draft process. So that is the time that you'll begin a lot of work on a lot of players.
Nice try, Drew.
The complexity of
you gave it away with the 5-month investigation.
There was going to be additional work needed to make sure to vet it as thoroughly as possible. So at that time, we had made no specific decisions, really probably anywhere on the roster, but we were trying to make sure that we obviously had enough time to do as much work as we could.
It's a contradictory statement, so we'll leave it at that.
No, I mean, I think I've mentioned to you guys before that, like, every offseason,
we'll try to
look at player availability
improve every
process if we have an expansion team.
And they're classy,
certainly as
so they're not going to be like, we knew right away that he wasn't the guy.
We did think through a number of different possibilities, but I can't say that there was a specific decision.
I knew they were going to be nice to Baker. They should. They own it.
Deshaun, why should you be believed instead of more than 20 women?
I can't speak on what people opinions are, because everyone have their own opinions, but what I can continue to do is tell the truth, and that is I've never assaulted or disrespected or harassed any woman in my life. Like I said before,
Third
I was
denial.
Raised differently. That's not my DNA, that's not my culture, that's not me as a person, and that's not how I was raised. And for me, that's to continue to push forward and show people that who I really am. And a lot of people haven't met me before. A lot of people haven't spoke to me before. A lot of people haven't been in the same environment as me before. And I want to continue to open that up and be able to have people, come to me and be able to talk to me about, certain things.
Are you trying to settle the 22 civil suits?
That's not my intent. My intent is to continue to clear my name as much as possible. And that's what I'm focused on.
Not a no.
Yeah, Andrew, can you explain why structured the contract in a way in which that if Watson is suspended by the NFL this season,
not a no, not
less than $60,000 per game loss out of a contract that's going to pay him $230 million guaranteed?
Yeah, Jake, it's a. I appreciate the question, and I think you guys know I typically don't talk about contracts in this setting. I actually will make a departure from that because I do think a little bit of context is important. So a couple things. Number one, we certainly understand the optics of it. I think for us, after we got comfortable with Deshaun, the contract was really a football decision. The things that were important to us from a club perspective were to have another year, have Deshaun under contract for another year, and to have it structured in a manner that would allow us, maximum flexibility to execute the rest of our
offseason. Plus, don't forget, they might have to pay Baker's salary or a portion of it.
They got to straighten Denzel Ward out, right?
The next steps with Baker and Baker's contracts.
Right. Clowney.
No, our cap. I think probably
they need the money this year. They'll off a bunch of dudes next year, like they did this year, Treader and Hooper and all that, to make more room.
We already have that. We so a lot of the larger player contracts that we already have on the books.
If NFL needs to take a look at their enforcement, if it can be circumvented so easily.
I'm sorry.
The NFL take a look at the way that they enforce, given that the. It can be circumvented so easily in terms of financial penalty.
You know, I that's not something that I can speak to. That's probably a better question for the league. I can just talk through really the club considerations from our perspective.
So one more, if Deshaun was coming to Cleveland, as he just said, before you even talked about the contract, why give him a new contract that not only was new, but the richest in NFL history for a single contract in terms of guaranteed money by a full.
That was the understanding. Wherever he got traded, he was going to get a new deal.
Getting an additional year of control was very important for us, Jake.
Let's go, Mary Kay, Jeff, Scott.
Because the additional year of control was important.
Deshaun, I'm wondering, kind of specifically, what kind of work are you willing to do, both in the community and personally, to either atone for anything if you feel like you have to do that, or just to make sure that you are never accused of anything like this going forward? And I mean specifically, working with any, women's groups or
good question.
Any other things in the community, sort of looking for specifics of what you plan to do.
Definitely. And I think, especially on the ending of that question, working with women groups, I think it has to be something that I have to earn that trust, to be honest. I have to earn that trust back into the community so I can step out. I don't want to just jump out and make it seem like I'm not doing it. I'm just doing it just to try to clear my name. I've always been
a community
with Habitat for Humanity, with Kids for Cancer, because my mom had tongue cancer, with education, giving back to schools, and then also with just, all types of charity work around the community of building communities, building housing and things. So,
I feel a little bad, Paul, I'm not gonna lie.
And my team the perfect opportunity for us to come out and just help. Because I've always been that type of person. That's how I was raised. That's why I continue to say
I kind of agree.
Because I wrote a book on it. That's how I was before any of these allegations. But at the same time, I know, and I'm not naive to the point that I have to earn that trust back from the community and people outside that's looking, at these allegations and haven't spoke to me before. So that's my goal, is to be able to earn that trust and keep pushing forward.
Quick follow-up on that. Personally, I mean, even if you do feel you're innocent of these and you've never done any of these things and the Browns don't feel like you have, will you be willing to do things, personally in terms of counseling or whatever else it would take?
Aaron's
to show
trying to text me right now, folks.
Extra mile.
Aaron is crushed that he is not here with us right now. Aaron, if you were
hey, there might be several requests at the bottom, can I join?
And that's what I've been saying from the beginning. So the situation is definitely.
Paul, how much wood did you chop this year?
But me having a problem going to counseling and things like that, I'm willing to talk to people about certain situations to make sure I'm not getting back in this. But like I said before, I never assaulted anyone, never disrespected anyone. I've always been respectful, and that's what I've always.
That's it. Four denials.
Yes, ma'am. Jeff,
that's it. Two more. Hold on.
I want to go back to 40 massage people. So if why not just find one you really like?
Well, I never. As far as the team, and when I say team, not saying the Cleveland Browns, but my agency and things like that, 40 is just over the time. It's not in one period of time. I've been in Houston for 5 years, so you go to different people, and that's just how, like I said before, that's I can't get too far into the details, but, as businesses work and you move and meet different people and people have different schedules and blocks, you kind of meet people over time.
Okay. Then the second one is a football question. What kind of quarterback are the Browns getting?
Yes, you're getting a strong leader who loves to work, who loves to make sure he uplifts everyone around him, who's going to compete super, super hard, who's going to fight to the end of time of each and every game, and a guy that is, like I said, is going to push everyone to their full potential so we can win a lot of Super Bowls.
Scott,
a lot of Super Bowl. I just want to get to one Super Bowl.
Difficult sell to say yes, this is the right move to make.
Yeah, I can't speak for everyone in the organization, Scott. That probably would be inappropriate. But I think we had a broad number of people, men and women in the decision making group, and we all did feel comfortable with the trade and the trade.
Has anybody left the Browns?
Yeah, after the body.
No,
that we were able to.
Right, nobody's left the Browns.
You expect they made the Deshaun to be suspended by the NFL? And if so, have you been able to get a feel for how long that might be or when that might go into effect?
We've had an open line of communication with the NFL, and we'll cooperate with the investigation as appropriate. They have their own process that they have.
Electronic merchant systems gets run on ESPN. With that, how about SportsCenter taking this for how many minutes each?
Oh, we're going 27.
30. So it was a 30. I knew it would be a 30. They want to. So,
thank you. Sean, I heard what you said about not being able to get into a lot of specifics in these cases, but broadly, with 22 women filing these suits, what can you tell us about what actually happened with these women? Are you saying that they all just made this up, they're all lying? What actually happened?
All I can say is, again, I never assaulted, I never disrespected, and I never harassed any woman in my life. I wasn't raised that way. My mom and my aunties didn't raise me that way. Over the course of my life, that's not in my DNA. And as far as the details of actually the things that they're alleging, I can't speak on that because there's an ongoing investigation. But, in the future.
I mean, what more do you want? The kids denied it.
I would sit down and love to talk about it.
There you go.
In the future,
there you go.
There to hear.
Can you explain that?
You get from 0 to 22 lawsuits.
I mean, I can't control that. You know, the only thing I can control is continue to clear my name, cooperate with any legal force or any legal system that is requiring me to cooperate, and just keep pushing forward.
Kimberly Mark.
Kimberly Mark, ESPN. Andrew, you mentioned several times that you got to a point where we felt comfortable, and it's a 5-month odyssey. It's been a few weeks since two grand juries decided not to, didn't have enough evidence for criminal charges. So exactly at what point did you feel comfortable? Because 5 months ago, there was still the threat of potential criminal charges.
They were
charges.
Happy with their own investigation.
Exactly what made you feel comfortable, and when was
Kimberly
that?
Kimberly, yeah. Yeah, Kimberly, yes, what I mentioned, I forgot who, I think Daryl might have asked it a little bit earlier. No, I understand. I don't know that I could pinpoint necessarily a specific date, but certainly as we got closer to the grand jury proceedings, we had gathered enough information.
All they were waiting for, folks, regarding was for the grand jury to say no criminal charges. Once that happened, the Browns were ready to go. They were already comfortable.
It was certainly
with their own investigation.
They might have even felt like there wouldn't be.
We felt good about the information that we had.
And then once there wasn't, they acted. The timeline is well documented.
Mentioned the word optics. So from the outside, the optics look like an elite player worth the risk. Are the optics correct that if he were not as talented, the organization would not have gone down this path and done the due diligence as they did?
Kimberly, I would tell you that on the one hand, any player we would try and do as much work on as possible. And then on the other hand, if we didn't get comfortable with Deshaun the person, it wouldn't have mattered how talented he was, we wouldn't have pursued the trade.
Let's go Tyler's in front, then we're going to go Cam, then we're going to go Nate.
Deshaun, have you had conversations with your teammates to kind of clear the air or explain to them who you are?
Yes, a lot of teammates reached out to me when the trade was happening or when the information, the news came out. But I've known a lot of people in that locker room also, just from the course of high school, college, and just playing against our some guys that were in Houston with me and vice versa. So a lot of the guys have definitely reached out. We've definitely talked, and a lot of guys know me as a person, and I'm going to continue to guys.
I think the locker room is down.
Once they get in April, I think it's the 18th.
Yeah. Supreme talent talks when you're in an NFL locker room.
People that are never going to believe you. Can you live with that?
Sure.
All I can do is continue to just stay focused and speak the truth, speak my honesty, and just keep trying to help other people. I can't speak for everyone else.
Kim?
Andrew, this organization has been like a cornerstone for making women feel inclusive in the NFL. Amid the nature of these allegations, were there conversations with the women you have in this staff when you were considering bringing him in, and how much did they weigh into the conversation when it came down to making it?
Did he have questions with who?
Cam, there absolutely were. And you know, we've talked a lot about building a diverse group within the organization and bringing all the perspectives to the table.
One of your owners is female.
And that's certainly something that
and she had to sign off
we did with this decision as well.
Have you had conversations with the women in this organization? And what is the message to not only those in this organization, but the fans who are looking at this decision and feel concerned about it?
I've only been here a day, so I hadn't been able to meet everyone. But, you know, as the time continues and I'm in the building, like I said before, I want people to be able to come to me and have an open dialogue and we speak about it and show the person I really am. And that's how I was raised, to respect everyone and continue to respect people like I want to be respected. And that's just how I was raised. So, you know, continue to build that with the organization and build that trust.
Andrew, is the contract guaranteed in the event of a suspension, or is there something different about this contract than a usual NFL contract that stipulates that?
I'm sorry, I didn't quite catch what you
said. Is the contract guaranteed in the event of a suspension?
No, if you get suspended, the NFL
takes I'm still not quite following.
So, with guaranteed money, isn't it usually the case that the guarantees are voided in the event of a suspension from the NFL? Is that the case with this contract?
I understand. So Nate, you know, again, I won't go into all the specifics with the contract, but we do have our language within the contract that, you know, does offer, I would say, you know, typical club protections. So.
That's a yes.
So for Kevin and Andrew, there are a lot of, you guys that said that you understand the sensitive nature of this. There are a lot of, you know, Browns fans who may have been affected by sexual assault, whether they're victims or they know victims. People who just think it's wrong to trade for a player with this number of allegations that he's still facing in the legal system. And a lot of people are saying, we're out, we're done with the Browns.
Not a lot.
What do you say to the people who say, I can't root for this?
Not our audience at all.
You know, Nate, I would tell you that...
go to the everybody's got to make their own decision, Andrew. Oh, he's stumped.
We'll never fully be able to walk in the shoes of individuals who have been affected by sexual assault. And that... is something that, you know, we thought about a lot as we went through this process, understanding, what the reaction would be. And that's something that weighed heavily on me. And we empathize with that emotion. We empathize with that sentiment. And at the same time, we also do feel good about the work that we did as we vetted this transaction.
They don't think he did it, folks. Get it?
We do have confidence in faith.
They don't think he did.
As a person.
Yep.
And
I don't believe that did the Browns decision, would have signed Deshaun Watson if they thought he assaulted 22.
Between the,
I'm sorry.
The information I don't think they would have. Working through due process, working through the legal process, you know, we do think that this is a decision that, as it's evaluated over the long run, will be something that
feel like he's going to be exonerated.
And we totally respect and totally empathize with those sentiments right now, totally understand that there are people who are not comfortable with the transaction right now.
Rightfully
but again,
so.
We followed our information. We feel good about Deshaun as a person, and we think that he's going to do a lot of positive in the community.
There you go.
We got time for three more.
Three more. Wow. So it's a 45.
Yeah.
It's a 45.
Thank you. Andrew and
or 40.
Kevin, I know you guys said you talked to a lot of people and you talked to a lot of women. I'm sure this came up at the dinner table. Did you talk to your wives? And what
great question.
You know, I think for all of us, and
we don't talk business at the dinner table.
This is, it's difficult. It's hard. Just like we were talking about earlier with Nate, this is not easy. And I certainly have sincere empathy for anybody who's a victim of sexual abuse in any way. So these are hard, hard conversations. And obviously, I'm sure just like, Browns fans and my family, it's something that you talk about. And it's those are uncomfortable conversations that are hard, but I think there's growth that comes out of those conversations. And certainly, I think there's a positive that can come out of this with those conversations.
Kevin hasn't said much. Nobody really asked him.
He's not even need to be here.
Yeah. Impact on the
That's a, he's a football.
I can tell you, just with my time spent with Deshaun in the past few days and getting to know him and getting to know this person, I'm looking forward to this community getting to know this person.
Kevin, I was a quarterback with vastly different skill set.
There you go, Tom. Good job. How
the changes in your offense does Deshaun not force but encourage?
We're going to work through it. We're going to spend a lot of time with Deshaun and the coaches and sit down and make
well,
sure.
Well, they are going to change the offense. Good.
Obviously, we have some good players that we're excited about.
On our have an option.
Yeah, right.
So our challenge right now that we have to work through is figure out ways that we want to pivot, ways we want to adapt to make sure that.
Well, that sounds to me like they're going to work on it.
To his best of his abilities.
Smart. They're smart.
Yeah, I think just if you watch a bunch of what Deshaun's done in his past, there's similarities to what
people seen Pumpkinhead.
There's some differences, and that's our job that we're working hard on and understanding where we want to move to. So, yeah, I do think you'll see differences.
For Deshaun, on this whole off-the-field situation, do you have any regrets on anything? And if so, what were they?
I don't have any regrets. Like I said before, the things that are off the field right now that came up, caught me by surprise because I never did anything that these people are alleging. And I know a lot of people say that I took the year off, and I used that to be able to clear my name like the previous 2 weeks and just to continue to fight that. And I just continue to work and become a better person, a better player, and just a better son. Like my mom has always taught me.
What's the hardest part?
With just football, just life, just.
The hardest
part. I think the hardest part is just, having everyone, come at me from different directions and without, me be able to publicly speak on it because of the ongoing investigation. But, I took the route of following my legal team and telling the truth to the legal side so I can bring my innocence. And then once, like I said before, it's resolved.
It doesn't sound like a guy who's going to sell lawsuits, but
right.
We'll see.
Even saying when it's resolved, I have no problem talking about it.
Obviously, you've talked about the investigation and the research. Deshaun is obviously maintaining his innocence. After all of that, do you and does this organization believe there was no wrongdoing?
Is that, Dan, we feel very confident in Deshaun.
Yes, that's a yes. It's what I told you 10 minutes ago. It's why you're watching this live.
We believe that as he gets into the community and our organization, he's going to make a positive impact.
Yes.
All right, we're going to close with a photo. Thanks, everyone.
All right. So hold on. How do you feel?
All right, there you have it. Deshaun Watson, Andrew
Nikki,
Berry.
Turn us down, please. Thank you.
I feel better. I don't think it could have went any better for them up there. Deshaun has said the whole time, I am innocent, and he stuck to it. It's probably a lot easier to pay and make everything go away, but the fact that he dug his heels
he
in.
He still might have to do that if you want to move on and play football. Right. Paul, how do you feel? You were very critical of this move, Chris.
Yeah, I do feel better. But actions will speak louder than words when it's all said and done. And whether that's how these 22 cases turn out, I ended up going back and listening to some of the testimonies from the women who had accused one. Because I wanted to be fair and not
I read
just
it
listen.
All too. And the Sports Illustrated article alone was
right.
pretty weird.
I'll be honest, it's the last thing I'm seeing and hearing, so it's tough to feel like, off of that, it's tough to feel like he's lying. Mm-hmm. Clearly, one side is just flat out lying.
Right.
I mean, that's what we've come to. That one side of this.
See, and I don't
are different versions of the truth. Or,
there you go. Sure. I think people might feel like they're violated, whereas one side didn't feel like it was a violation, and that's a real slippery slope. Here's my takeaway from this: this kid has professed his innocence publicly now. That's what I wanted to see. Mm-hmm. I wanted to see if he was, because if they went to the, hey, we're not going to talk about anything regarding the, they didn't do that. Everybody talked about it openly. Coach, GM, and player. I thought that was really good. If you're a Browns fan, you should feel good about it. Did he do this? Who knows? Is he going to play this year? We really don't know. Right. But I thought this was a pretty good start. All right, do I sign off now on Insta Live? Look, everybody's getting on with me now.
Well, the show's over. I've had to pee for 45 minutes. I got to go.
Rob, what do I hear?